for Atatu up against the Ellerslie Eagles. And as you can see on screen there, it is Atatu who take a 12-6 lead into the break. Three tries, all unconverted, while Ellerslie have the one converted try. Certainly an action-packed first half, Troy. A sin-binning and plenty of enterprising play, but the common theme, penalties conceded, which have cost both teams. Discipline, probably a real issue for both sides through their opening 40.
Absolutely, and it sort of evened up towards the end there. You know, Te Aratu were way out in front on the penalty count. Just having a quick look, you know, it looks like it's 6-3, so Ellerslie Black with a few penalties there. But the other telling factor too was Te Aratu's handling errors. Ellerslie's managed to keep the ball in hand. They've had one handling error as we get ready for Ella to kick off and to start the second half. So it'll be, would have been nice to be a fly on the changing room walls in regards to what's been given instructions for the next 40, and here we go.
So back to it we go, and Te Aratu with first use of the ball bounces kindly for Isaac Miski, who then hands off to big Donovan Briggs, who's on for his second stint of the game, and we've got a strip on the first play. So just as we finish talking about discipline and penalties, Ellerslie come up with the strip on the first play of the second half. Some halftime updates. Well, there's only the one from this competition, the championship. Pukekohe trailing 6-8 over Manukau at halftime. But up in the first division, the Fox Memorial Premiership, the Glenora Bears hold an 18-0 lead over the Otahu Leopards. Northcote and Howick, they're locked up at 10 points apiece at the break. Richmond lead Bay Roskill 12-4. Marist up 22-4 over the Manurewa Marlins. And Poinchevlea with a narrow 16-12 lead over Papakura at the break. So Urquhart jumps into dummy half and then comes back to Briggs. And hasn't he been hard to bring down, still driving those legs and makes five or seven post-contact metres. But really impressive in the front row for the Roosters. Urquhart, the dummy half, it won't matter. There's a penalty for crowding. So back-to-back penalties on this first use of the ball.
And we'll be collecting them like nobody's business.
A tap and go. Makiri bumps the ball forward there. 20 out from the line. Briggs comes back to the inside this time, and another penalty. Three penalties in a row for Ellerslie on their first defensive set of the second half.
He's marched them.
So Urquhart with the tap and the go. Makiri bumps off one, still going. Balls come loose. There was multiple people in that tackle. Is that going to be a strip? One-on-one was the call, but then there's a knock-on in there. So it will be Te Aratu ball. No penalty, though. It was a one-on-one strip originally. It was a nice little play in theory. Had the ball knocked on, and now Te Aratu to pack down and feed the scrum 10 metres off the line.
Bit of a discussion going on there too.
So Miski to feed the scrum. Urquhart receives at the back. And Hakaraya, a difficult one for Taulu to pull in, and then the ball is a mile off and in over the top. So Te Aratu Roosters waste all of that possession. They've literally had the ball for three straight minutes to start this second half. And it all comes to an end with a wayward pass. The Ellerslie Eagles hold on.
On those opening exchanges, you'd have to think that if the head coach for Ellerslie Eagles has asked for discipline and patience, he hasn't got it yet.
Ellerslie coming into this match in third position on the ladder. Te Aratu Roosters just behind in fifth. Comes after Te Aratu made the second tier Charmin Cup Grand Final last year, finished as runners-up, going down to New Lynn in that final. While the Ellerslie Eagles third in the regular season of that competition. dominant tackle that time. They put him down. 45 out. Off their own line here as Antonovich bunts, kicks, and it's under pressure. And it will be fielded on the full. And now Taolu gets the chance to run back at them. And he's got a little bit of open space in front of him. Takes it forward and gets to his fronts as well. Another penalty. Boy, oh boy. Time off. We're going to have a talking to here. So the call from Green, all different issues, so no one will be sitting down, but in no uncertain terms told to clean their act up a little. Roosters kick for touch. And we'll start this set 40 out from the line. Shout out to the Auckland Rugby League Referees Association. Give them a like on Facebook and visit their website if you're interested in getting involved. Urquhart to Briggs. Briggs looking for that offload, and Taolu was hovering around. Urquhart gets to the play of the ball now. Hakaraya turns back to the inside. Big contact that time and doing really well.
Offloaded. Sorry, Corey.
Was Nelisi there? Miski gets on the end of the second phase. Now he's looking for an offload. They've had hardly any ball in this second half, the Ellerslie Eagles. Been asked to do a whole lot of defense. Hakaraya turns back to the inside. There's a good tackle that time, and leading the charge is Cover, who's been impressive for the Eagles. Urquhart to Hakaraya, who kicks in behind, regathers himself, and Tiaratu are in again. Boston Hakaraya does it all on his own. This will make for pretty viewing on the replay. Some individual brilliance here from the Tiaratu standoff.
Crown lift trucks action replay. Great little ball out from the ruck. And he went to dribble through, bounced off one of the Ellerslie players, popped right up into his chest plate, and hello, try time. And just having a look at the body language around the ground, you know, see him there on the replay, not really the way to start the second half.
Well, when they put themselves under so much pressure, Troy, with those penalties, like I said, they have hardly touched the ball in the first 6 minutes of the second half, and eventually that pressure had to tell. They did well to hold on initially, but in the end, the other two get the desired result, and Hakaraya now back on kicking duties by the look of it.
You're right, it's all been one-way traffic. It's all been the other two ball. Ellerslie's touched it once to complete a set. But, you know, four penalties in the second half. How many minutes gone? Four, just as many.
So Hakaraya to attempt the conversion. Strikes it, and another one that is away. Yet to land a conversion today, the Tiaratu Roosters. And you look at that scoreboard, yeah. Troy, and you imagine if they had kicked those, it'd be a commanding lead right now. But as it stands, instead it's 10 points, and Ellerslie are certainly still in this match.
Ellerslie need to fire up now.
So Antonovich bunts, gets us back underway. It's fielded by Miski, who's got Briggs there with him. Instead, we'll go himself, and now they work it down this left-hand side. So keen to keep playing adventurous football are the Tiaratu Roosters, and that time looked likely for a minute. They thought they might go downfield. Instead, Ellerslie do well to scramble back and contain it. This is Jordan Tua, who carries the ball forward, one of the many players who came across from Mount Albert this year. Brother of Jared Tour, of course, who left the field in the first half with that injury. Briggs, what about that? Now, this might be off the foot from Taolu. Connell's there to clean it up anyway, but what about the work of this Donovan Briggs? Some brilliant carries so far in this match, and that time had the second phase on the end of it to boot. Quick play the ball now for the Eagles. Up over halfway they go. Prescott's into dummy half. Fighting for that quick one here, and he's going to dart as George Prescott. And we'll earn the penalty as well. High shot there, and the man pinged, I think it was Eric Golding. Antonovich bunts, quick to Go and retrieve the ball here, and he will kick this one into touch. Does so safely. They'll start this set 20 metres out from the line. 16-6, Te Atatu Roosters over the Ellerslie Eagles. 49 minutes gone here at Jack Colvin Park. You're with us for round four of the Crown Lift Trucks Fox Championship qualifiers. Here is a tap and go, and stuck his nose through a little gap there, but tackled well by Jordan Tua in the end. Now at dummy half, Nalisi to Taylor. Taylor to Vili Lee. Williams at dummy half. Looping ball to Antonovic Bunce, who finds his back rower at pace, but Te Atatu looking nice and organised on their line. Williams, Antonovic Bunce will go himself. He'll go very close here. Williams will burrow. Short is the call. Last tackle now coming up. Ellerslie looking for their second try of the game. Taylor kicks in behind. It's cleaned up. There's a penalty here. Inside the 10 is the call. This will be an Ellerslie ball. And a chance now to have another crack at them. This is better from the Ellerslie Eagles. Recovered from that rocky old start. Williams it is who taps and goes. This is Tua. Tua will go close, but Briggs holding on and just manages to spin him and keep him away from that try line. Short ball. Burrowing low, but Te Atatu are there in numbers. There's blue shirts everywhere. Vili Lee gets to the play of the ball. This is Taylor. Got Connell on his outside. Faced heavy pressure and did well to step out of a couple before being taken to the ground. This will be a quick play of the ball now. Williams to Antonovic Bunce to Tua. Tua with a fend. Gets out of one before Briggs gets back hold of him and takes him to ground. They're right up against the line here. The Te Atatu Roosters resolute in their defense. Williams, a looping ball. Antonovic Bunce, a cutout one into the corner. Is that a try? Bundled into touch is the call. Great defense, Te Atatu Roosters, and they hold on here. 16 points to 6. It is the Roosters who lead over the Ellerslie Eagles. 51 minutes gone here at Jack Colvin Park.
So great defense there. Roosters managed to repel the Eagles just on that left-hand edge on the corner post. And some of the big boys there will be getting a breather in just as they get ready to set the scrum.
Galton. Okay, the first one there before being taken to ground.
Certainly manhandled him in that tackle.
Dumped to ground that time. Jordan Tua, and it's going to earn a penalty there. Well, time off. I'm interested to hear the explanation here. Certainly was heavy contact, but not immediately clear what was illegal. So penalty sufficient in the eyes of Green, which will give Te Atatu a chance to kick for touch here. Cortez Taulu up, keen to have a chat. He's obviously assumed the captaincy in Jared Tua's absence.
Te Atatu march down the field, and just on that, speedy recovery to Jared. Like to see him back for next week, so hopefully it's not too serious. Bit of a character.
Urquhart joining in there, trying to get the quick play of the ball and pushing the player out of the way. There's good contact from the Ellerslie defence, and Skelton looking to turn fortunes for his side off the back of some good defence. Vili Lee that time down low. Hakaraya. Back to the inside. Here we go. Here's a really good carry from Makiri. Quick play of the ball as well, and there'll be a chance on the edges here. Urquhart to Miski. Miski, ball in both hands, is taken the ground. 10 metres out from the line. Urquhart back to the middle of the park. Hakaraya to Briggs. Briggs looking for an offload. Gets it. Hakaraya kicks in behind. The ball is loose, and it's cleaned up by Billy Lee. But entertaining footy that time from the Tiratu Roosters. Ellerslie do really well to hold on, and now have got some work to do as they look to ruck this ball out from deep inside their own half. Inside the 10 as it is right now. And one out running from them so far. They'll need something special here, or perhaps a penalty just to get themselves out of trouble. Was that high? Yes, it was. Just what they needed that time, the Eagles. They get the penalty.
Yeah, so that ball's coming towards the camera, and hopefully over our cameras. Another Steedon back onto the park.
So 54 and a half gone. It is the Eagles sitting on, I should say, the Roosters sitting on a 10-point lead. Williams.
Is it just me? Ellerslie looking a bit flat. They're just standing back.
And they need a spark, don't they? And you wonder who the man to deliver that could be. Connell's looked likely from the back. Well, Antonovich Bunce has been active as well. And that's really poor that time. Spills out over the sideline. And no pressure built. And Te Aratu packed down a scrum 30 metres off their own line.
Everyone's casually walking into the scrum. So, from the coach's point of view, I'd be lost words in regards to they really need to engage in up-tempo here.
Right, on you.
And here comes another wave of attack from the Roosters.
Good, good, contact, good. Put them down together, and then hold, hold. Go on.
He's been busy, that young man.
He has indeed. Anthony Goulton having a really, really good game. We mentioned he's come across from the Ponsonby Ponies and scored the first two tries, set up the third, and he's been busy as well, hasn't
the big bookend
shirked his responsibility in work. And you're right to point out, Troy, as well, Briggs, who's had a telling impact on this game so far as well. Golding plays at the line, gets taken out in back play. Play on is the call. They're 45 out from the line now, the Tiratu Roosters. A lead by 10, looking to add to that. Hakaraya at the line, Taulu chiming in. Antonovich Bunce, the man to take him down. Hakaraya kicks across the body, and it is cleaned up by Prescott. And ball's now come loose. This is play on. Te Aratu ball. Anthony Goulton now jumps out of one. Goulton gets it away now down to the right side, and David Dyer will go over in the corner. David Dyer adds his second try of the match. Anthony Goulton at the heart of it once again. Let's take a look at the replay here. It's an athletic finish in the end from David Dyer, but it comes from a loose carry. The ball spills loose, and the Tiratu Roosters take full advantage. See there, it's just spilled out. Heads up play from Maipi. This is brilliant from Goulton. The big goose step to stand up one, breaks out of that, and then from here, he always knows Dyer's there. Connell had no choice but to go for the intercept. He was left with a 2-on-1, and then David Dyer with the nice finish in the corner, and the Tiratu Roosters stretch this out to a 22-6 lead, 56 and a half points gone.
As we wait for the kicker to strike, big thank you to SAS Sporting Apparel, major sponsors of the Fox Premiership, and Crown Lift Trucks, the major sponsors of the Fox Championship.
So the third goal kicker, the other two have used so far in this game. And remember, they are yet to add one. Can Miski be the first? And well, it was probably one of the better kicks we've seen, but away is the call. And It remains Teletu Roosters 20, Ellerslie Eagles 6, 58 minutes gone here at Jack Colvin Park. And you just wonder, Troy, if that may be the telling blow. Ellerslie were just stubbornly hanging in the contest there, but that will be a big, big blow for them. They've endured some rough times in this second half, have had hardly any ball and have leaked two tries already. And if they're going to have a response, it needs to be pretty soon. And they need some energy. You mentioned it before.
Absolutely.
The talk's gone and the body language isn't looking great at this point.
So here come the Roosters again, and their tails are up.
Briggs, straight back at them. He's met, though. Good contact. Manawika on for his second spell. Makiri. Quick play of the ball. Might be on the end of it. Ball spills loose. Bob now picks it up. This will be a knock on each way. This should be an Ellerslie ball. And it will be. So the Ellerslie Eagles now get their chance on the footy. And Troy, one thing to note, it does appear that the Teletu Roosters are playing two men down, Jared Tuagon and Dylan Murray. So perhaps just makes this effort all the more impressive. Both of those players going off with what appeared to be knee injuries.
Well, both the reserves that have come on, they've certainly done the job as well. I like the look and shape of the 15. He's certainly been active and busy. And, you know, as you rightly said, the Eagles really need to start sweeping in on collecting tries here because the Roosters are out of the coop, ladies and gentlemen, and they are free range.
An hour in and we get our first bird punt. That was very restrained of you, Troy Hardy, to wait that long as Antonovic bunts now with a bit of trickery involving his fullback, Marcelo Connell, and a penalty as well, a high shot there. And it does look very much as if they are going to spark something here. It's going to be off the back of Antonovic bunts as he fails to find touch. I've well and truly put the mocker on him that time, and then well, there's a fair bit going on there. They trap him in goal. It's ruled to be a high tackle. And now we have time off for a chat.
Well, I'd only just circled the penalty box, and then, hello, we're back into an error. I'm not coming up with another bird pun, because I feel like you're pecking on me.
Come on. I'm speechless. Teletu to kick for touch. Right on the hour mark. And really a comedy of errors on that last play.
Right, easy here. Bring it up, bring it up. Wait here, yep. Wait. Guys. Up together! Stand ho!
He's been a handful that week.
Yes, Seamus McKitty off the bench, the 26-year-old, has certainly been active. And for those boys, Troy, having to play bigger minutes as well, obviously, with the two injuries.
Absolutely, yeah, and it's an opportunity for each of them to be able to play themselves into the side.
Hakaraya goes short. David Dyer was just about through a gap there. Urquhart now at the dummy half and comes back to Hakaraya, who's appearing at first receiver a lot in this game. Miski. Was that knocked on? Play on's the call. Taken down on halfway. Last tackle coming up. Hakaraya, they'll run it on the last and hand over here. So that's a good result for Ellerslie. Crossfield this time from Pisatua. Prescott now jumps into dummy half. He goes for another run. He's been very good in a team that is trailing on the scoreboard today, Prescott. As Andrew Bob bumps it forward. Taken down low, but gets to a quick play of the ball as well. The Ellerslie Eagles got a nice little roll on now. They need some shine at the end of the set, though. They need points. 62 minutes gone. They trail by 14. Taylor to Connell. Connell holds it up. Good sliding defence though from the Teletu Roosters. Miski gets there in time to deny Robert Malisea. Connell now the dummy half. We'll shuffle it back to the middle where Taylor will throw a big looping cutout pass which finds the big prop. The basketball pass out the back that is knocked on. And once again it breaks down for the Eagles.
Play the ball over there.
And there just seems to be no urgency.
Yeah, over here, boys.
The other two are quite happy to just loll around out here at Jack Colvin.
Take it over. Boys, over here.
Yep, and we'll move over to the spot here. I believe we will play the ball.
Just here. Take it over.
Yeah, go to the pit. No, a bit further. Hey, okay. This will do? Okay.
Even the match officials are laughing. Back to it we go, finally. Some rugby league to talk about once again. And boy, coming in over the top there. With a potentially big contact, didn't quite catch the number. But Ellerslie now keen to make an impact defensively. And there's a good hit that time from the number 11, Elliot Nalisi. The 22-year-old edge forward. Urquhart, back to the middle, little change of direction that time. There's a good carry forward. Urquhart jumps out, tackled down low by Taylor. Hakaraya to Goulton. Keen to move this ball now as they get it to David Dyer. Steps back infield, 40 out from the line. This will be the last tackle. Hakaraya goes high, although perhaps didn't get the purchase on it he would have wanted that time. It's brought under control by Tua, who is dumped to ground. Good kick chase that time, and it's Isaac Miski inflicting the pain that time on Tua. Robert Malisea, we haven't seen a lot of him so far in this game. Does well to earn a penalty that time. He's an interesting story, Robert Malisea. He's a high performer at Taekwondo as well, a regular at the World Championships this decade, 2011 to 2013, representing his country. He also played for the Vulcans under-20s back in 2016.
A bad kick. Just out in front of us here, halfway.
So Malisea gets us back underway to Taylor. And plenty will be asked of the forward pack here for the Eagles. Andrew Bob and Manuika need some good carries here. And on cue there is big Manuika, who takes a couple with him, trying to get to his front to get to that quick play. The ball, ball's loose. It's a strip.
Penalty.
So another shot at them here now. There's still time here for the Ellerslie Eagles. They just need to get things going and they need some points in a hurry. Andrew Bob. That's a hell of a way to start. Messi. Play on is the call. Taylor to Carver. Carver looking for an offload. Gets there eventually to Taylor. They got numbers here. Teatatu with a staggered line. Andrew Bob straight and hard. Ball comes loose. Another penalty and time off for another talking to.
That's three back-to-back penalties.
And if you're the Teletu Roosters here, Troy, this really plays into your favour because you just felt like Ellerslie were really starting to build some speed and momentum there, and now you get this break.
Just diffuse it a little bit. However, they need to get reshape on the line. They'll be desperate to keep them out here. And a wee bit more of a chat going on, so clever play by the captain.
A concerning sign in the background there is an ambulance at the ground, which will be for either Tua or Dylan Murray, I assume. So our thoughts go out to the injured player or players, as it may be on that occasion. Never nice to see. Manga to Bob. Bob goes low and hard. Gets put on his back, and there's half the Teletu Roosters team there to ensure the big fella does not crash over. Crucial moment in the game here for the Ellerslie Eagles. Manga looking to just dart and crash his way over, but Ellerslie not having luck on that occasion. Antonovic bunts. Terrible pass from dummy half. Ball is now loose. Ellerslie dodge a bullet there, do they? No, they do not. Well, It was a horrible pass out of dummy half. It left Taylor with next to no chance of bringing it in. It's a real shame because Antonovich Bunce has had a fine game, but on that occasion, probably a little bit of fatigue just creeping in there. And the Ellerslie Eagles let Tiatu off the hook. And with 13 minutes to play,
you have to wonder whether the head coach's crate for the boys tonight will be shelved till next weekend. Scrum packs in.
Miski with the feed. He's led the team around well today, has Isaac Miski, without overplaying his hand. Hakurai has probably been the more involved of the halves, but Isaac Miski really showing his class and jumping into dummy half when needed as well. David Dyer, there's another one who's been a fine performer. Two tries to his name. Urquhart jumps out. Hakurai gets hit hard on the 40. Goulton chips over the top. There's contact in the back play. It's not going to matter because Connell picks it up, and now a chance to counter for the Ellerslie Eagles. Has worked hard from the back, Connell, with minimal attacking opportunities. Another time off. As I think we've got a player down in back play.
On him.
Just looking at the Ellerslie shape out here, you know, all clustered up around the ruck.
Prescott with the carry, looking for the offload. It won't come this time. Manga centralised into the middle of the park. Off the back fence now comes cover. Gets rid of one. Eventually taken down under a three-man tackle. Last tackle coming up. Antonovich Bunce to Connell. Connell now chimes into the line. Brilliant tackle, Hakuraya. Boy, oh boy. Great defense. One-on-one. It was a must-make tackle. And he comes up with the goods, says Hakuraya.
On you! Hold here. Wait. Go. Afternoon! Green hole! Go one.
One marker.
He's okay. Asumasu!
So with 10 minutes to play, it does look like Tiatu will go on with the job here and inflict Ellerslie's first loss of the year on them. There's a hard tackle and it's ruled to be above the horizontal as well. So we get a penalty at the end of this, but super impressive today, the Tiatu Roosters. And really, despite the way the scoreboard looks, Ellerslie have just remained in this contest the whole way through.
I've been saving this one for you, Corey.
Bird pun time. Why do I get the feeling there's a bird pun on the way?
Roosters could be crying tonight at Jack Colvin. And that's coming right towards us. And manages to just bounce off the commentary box. Grant would be happy, our CTAS live stream partners, that didn't collect the camera. Coming up a wee bit.
So we'll run that time from Jordan Tour. Urquhart now to Golding. Golding will settle and gets bumped backwards. Manga involved in the tackle that time as well. Urquhart. Might be fighting for that quick play of the ball. Miski. Kicks over the top. Chase is good from Tiata 2. Connell's back there and just in the nick of time. Marcel Connell gets there to close it down. The 18-year-old fullback Part of the Warriors jersey flag set up.
Yep.
The Warriors jersey flag. Did they have Manly this weekend?
They played Penrith last weekend from memory. I'm not too sure actually, but.
I'm behind it.
A short one from Taylor. Well, that's brilliant.
There we go. The referee call on that.
Oh, I'm not sure what was the case on that one. Inside the 10 must be the call.
He was offside. Blue boot.
Offside is the call. Okay, well, it looked okay on first look, but good call from referee Green. Now penalty in front of the sticks, and they'll take the two here. Chew off another 3 minutes. Just extend that lead out now and close this game out.
Can't think back. Think back a wee bit earlier into the second half to those three penalties back to back that Ellerslie had, and then top that off with a handling error that was, an opportunity gone begging.
And you're right, it's probably where the game was won or lost, really, as it hung in the balance there. There's only 6 points in it at half time. As Hakaraya lines up this penalty from in front, and we should see
the first successful
conversion of the day. And we do. Flags are up, and Te Aratu extend the lead out to 22-6 as we approach the final 5 minutes here at Jack Colvin Park. And it's going to end up being a fairly convincing victory for the Te Aratu Roosters, who have done it with 15 men for much of the match following injuries to Jared Tour and Dylan Murray. Ellerslie did have Vili Lee Simbind midway through the first half. Plenty going on in this match, but Te Aratu Roosters just with too much class at the end of the day. Frustrating day at the office for TJ Ashford's men as we see a dropped ball here. This is put down by the Te Aratu back rower, Jai McCartney. So back to it we go. Ellerslie Eagles with a chance to at least end the game on a high. Prescott jumps out of dummy half. Gets the offload away out the back as well. Manga now on the ball. Te Aratu keen to protect this line and make sure there's not too much of a blemish on this result. Come full time, Prescott. Quick play the ball now. Prescott gets on the end of it. Borrowing his way over, gets close. No cigar this time. Manga, short at the line to Skelton. Put on his back. And this Te Aratu line, stoic today. Short they go. Taulu with the contact. That is brilliant defense. Te Aratu Roosters, you can hear the celebrations going on in back play, and fair enough as well. We can look at the scoreboard and say the 22 is impressive, but this defensive effort today, Troy, from the Te Aratu Roosters, they've just kept showing up.
Certainly have, and I think by the start of losing a couple of their big guns, you know, the reserves who came on certainly stood up, and they've played with a lot of pride today.
So inside the final 5 minutes now. Dyer.
Up together! Come in, hold!
Gulton. Makes a few metres before he's set upon and taken to ground.
Wait, go. Good.
Urquhart comes centre field. Makiri with another good carry. Maipi. Swinging out the back, Miski gets to his kick. It's a high one and way out on the full. And a penalty to Ellerslie, the result of that one. Connell weaving his way through a couple. Eventually wrestled to ground by Urquhart. Prescott now at dummy half, another dart. He's had plenty of running meters today, has George Prescott. Melissa, little change of direction, whizzes through the gap, holding on for dear life was David Dyer down low. Munger now, front foot ball here for the Eagles. Antonovic bunts, hands off to his center who has gone close here. There it is, they finally get their second try of the match. It's all too late, but it's Patrick Tulsi who goes over. Reaches out, slams the ball down. Flags are up. 22-12 with 2 minutes to go. Hi, Bob. Okay. Two with possibly the slowest walk back to halfway I have ever seen, and we're not even trying to disguise it, really. We've got time off anyway, but... So a deep one. The boot of Hakaraya and
very deep
kicked out on the full, and really with the game and the situation it is, a bizarre error from the Tiaratu Roosters. Surely you just play it safe there. They lead by 10 inside the final 2 minutes. The Aussie Eagles will get things going straight away. Melissa off the end of a quick play of the ball now. He will centralise about 30 metres out from the line. Manga comes out to the left edge. They're only 15 out from the line now, the Eagles. Skelton, backdoor, Taylor misses out. Connell finds cover. Cover then hands off to Tua on the wing, who gets bumped into touch, and that'll just about do it for us here from Jack Colvin Park as Tua goes down with cramp. And that will just about run the clock out. Do stay with us post-match. We'll hear from both captains, get their reaction from this match here at Jack Colvin Park. A big thank you to everyone who has tuned in to join us. I know there's a big following in Australia today as well, as the siren goes in the background, and that will do it. The Tiaratu Roosters win this one 22-12 over the Ellerslie Eagles here in the Crown Lift Trucks Fox Championship qualifiers. A very short break from us before we catch up with the captains post-match. Right, we're now joined by a very happy Cortez from the Te Atatu Roosters. Well, after a tough defeat a fortnight ago and the bye last week, that one must feel good.
Yeah, it feels very good, eh? We knew Ellerslie would come out here and give it to us, and just had to weather that storm. I'm grateful for the win, I guess, yeah.
You had to face some adversity along the way. You lost your captain, Jared Tour, and then Dylan Murray as well. Let's talk about the effort of those boys who had to play some bigger minutes today.
Yeah, mean effort from those boys, eh? Prayers go to Dylan and Jezza. Hopefully they get a speedy recovery and stuff. Happy to get the win for them.
The game was very much in the balance for a long time there. Where did you feel like it turned?
I think it was just a couple, you know, errors from Ellerslie. I think we capitalised on a couple of them. And yeah, I guess that's where it turned.
Your backline very good today, David Dyer in particular and Anthony Galton.
Oh yeah, can't be speedy, I guess. So yeah. He's got all of it.
Yeah. Excellent. Cortez, thanks for joining us and enjoy the night.
Sweet. Thanks. Thanks for looking for me.
Now going to welcome in Chance from the Ellerslie Eagles. Well, Chance, a tough one to take there, mate, in the game for much of the 80 minutes, but just fell away probably early in the second half.
Yeah, the boys dug deep where they could, and full credit goes to Tat with the injuries that they suffered early on, and their boys dug deep as well, played a lot of minutes. Our boys, yeah, just fell away. A couple of clinical errors that we let in, and they capitalised really well.
You were undefeated through the first 3 weeks, but what was missing today?
I'm not too sure. The boys, we prepped really well this week. I think we just got outplayed. Just between the 20s, the Tat boys found their fronts really well and dominated that ruck area. So I think full credit goes to them.
Perhaps a timely wake-up call of where you're at and what you need to improve on as we get into these qualifiers?
Definitely. No losses are ever welcome, but it's a good way to sort of, like you said, see where we are. And it's probably a good time to lose early rather than a bit later in the season when it matters more.
Yourself, mate, you've been around in both rugby and league. You enjoying life back at the Eagles?
I am. I haven't played league for a few years now, so it's been good to chuck the boots on and have a run around at Ella.
Chance, well, commiserations today on the defeat, but all the best for the rest of the season.
Yeah, cheers, thank you.
So that does it, ladies and gentlemen, for us here at Jack Colvin Park. We don't have a live stream game next week, but keep an eye on AucklandLeague.co.nz for the updates. We'll be back in action in a fortnight's time. We'll see you then.